Hola, está Keegan Connor Tracy, and you're listening to or watching, you're watching Criticologos. I think. I hope.
Ya fue media vida de Criticologos. Estoy con y me encuentro con Keegan Connor Tracy. Welcome to Criticologos and welcome to Puerto Rico.
Muchas gracias.
She knows Spanish, you know.
What is it? Me encanta.
Te encanta.
I'm happy. Happy. Yes, I'm happy to be here. Thank you.
Let's talk about your career in TV, from epic Battlestar Galactica to small station Supernatural to something really interesting in Bates Motel.
Yes.
Really interesting. Yeah. We'll talk about it later. From now, Once Upon a Time, since day one, since the first episode, and obviously now in The Magicians in sci-fi.
Yes.
I think you're proud. You have to feel proud. You have to be happy about everything you have done so far in your career, right?
Of course. Oh my gosh. Since I was a little girl, I wanted to be an actress, and I grew up and I got to do that every day. Well, maybe not every day, but I get to do that for my job, and I get to travel and meet really wonderful people and work with wonderful people. So you can't ask for much more than to get to do what you set out to do as a child.
Let's talk a little bit about Battlestar Galactica and the Magicians, they're both from Sci-Fi Channel. What is your favorite part about working both in Battlestar Galactica and working with The Magicians?
Well, Battlestar Galactica, you know, it was... you know, I like working all the time, but every once in a while you get on a show that just has like this great group of people, and I feel like Battlestar was that. It was also for me, I was pregnant on the first episode that I was in, and then I had my baby, and then when we were all in the court and doing all that stuff with Baltar, I had a brand new baby. So they were so wonderful to me to be able to let me, I had my baby on set, and you know, we would be working, and then they would do setup, and I would like run to my trailer and feed the baby and run back. And so it's all sort of tied up to this really important time in my life, in addition to having been just a really cool show to work on with really interesting people, and not necessarily just my storyline, but Battlestar as a whole, mm-hmm. I feel like was like a metaphor for society in general, and racism and politics and the future of where things are going to go. And I think that's one of the things about sci-fi is that they tend to be on the cutting edge of what's coming, and they can, for example, use aliens instead of a particular race to talk about what that means for America, what it means for the world. And I just feel like that was a big part of what that show was about. The Magicians is just a whole different ball of wax, isn't it?
Yeah. It's something different, something really new. And that's why I love about sci-fi, they like to take risks.
It's true. And I think that, you know, when I heard about The Magicians originally, I was, you know, I heard Harry Potter goes to college, and I thought, well, that sounds interesting. And then I got the show, and I thought, okay, I'm going to go look. And I read I started to read the books, and I just devoured all three of them. So I know what happens. And I just love to be part of these shows that are really breaking the mold, that are doing something different. And I'm just really happy to be on it.
Since you know what happened, and without giving too much away, what's going to happen in The Magicians? What can we expect from it?
Well, you know what? I honestly know what happens in the books. I don't know to what degree they're going to stick with the books, but I think that it will always be a surprising and really interesting show. I love the cast. I think it's so interesting how they cast that show. And I love watching them, so I'm looking forward to watching as a fan.
How about the Supernatural? You did a couple of episodes. How about working with Jared and Jensen? They're great guys.
Yes.
How was working with them?
It was good, except there's an awful lot of flatulence on that set with them. Have you heard this already? Yes. I was like, wow. And I think on the first one I was pregnant, and on the second one I had just had a baby. So that's what I remember about Supernatural.
Let's talk about risky, interesting Bates Motel. I thought you were going to go there. I'm a fan of the whole story about Morse Norman and Norma Bates. It's a risky show. It's a really, you know, interesting show, the way they're developing the whole persona of Norman.
Yes.
How was it to deal with that type of, it's really different to what you have done before, something that like that, so risky and so, you know, with a kid.
First of all, I think Bates Motel sort of broke the mold again, or like really was doing something different by taking a story and taking it out of context in time from where it was originally, to take it out of whatever it was, the 50s or something, and move it into modern times. I thought that was a very bold choice, and it was either going to work or it wasn't, and I thought they made it work. In terms of working that kind of character, there were days when I think because I was a woman playing, if that would have been a man with a young girl student, it would have had a very different vibe. And I felt like it was a very fine line for me to walk, because at the end of the day, she was kind of a pedophile. I mean, yeah. I think he was 16, so mm-hmm. technically, you know. But still, that was a very, very dangerous thing. And I had to, I felt like I needed to walk that line very, very carefully, because it could have been too much, or it could, you know, I feel like that character struggled with what was going on. Mm-hmm. And so I really tried to play that very finely.
Let's finish it. Once Upon a Time, you've been there from the beginning. I'm a huge fan of Lost, so working with the Lost guys,
the same people. Yes. The same
Carlton
people.
Cuse
also.
Of course. Yes. How were you expecting this show to be this huge?
No.
Gosh, I mean, I don't think, you never know. I mean, there are some pilots that are really great that don't go, or shows that are really great that don't go, and sometimes you see a script and you're like, oh, this is all right, and then you see it and you go, holy cow. And I feel like all the way along in the beginning of Once Upon a Time, you know, I had said in my Q&A that I had just had a baby, and I was sort of like, you know, I hadn't quite raised my head yet. So then when I took my little girl was 3, and I took her to the wedding scene from the pilot, mm-hmm. and when I saw that, I feel like I was like, oh, okay, this is bigger than I thought it was going to be. And then I saw the pilot, and I thought, oh my gosh, like it broke the mold. I keep saying this, but again, yeah, it did. We had never seen a show really, other than Lost, I suppose, which dealt a lot in flashbacks and things like that, but to take traditional fairy tales and twist them and turn them and interlock them in the way that Adam and Eddie have done has been an incredible thing.
Final question, what can we expect from Supriya and Lufrey? What's the character going? What's the direction?
I don't know. I really don't know. I would love to know more about what her story is and what motivates her. And, you know, I know there's a lot of people, like, people are always saying, we think she's the bad guy, which I'm really amused by, and I would love to explore that. That would be amazing.
Perfect. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity. Y seguimos aquí en Criticólogos.
Hola. Gusto conocerla.